Good evening. Welcome to Stambaugh Auditorium. You probably heard that already, huh? We don't have a microphone backstage, so you didn't really know that was going to be a suspense event, but thank you for participating. What a pleasure it is to be here this evening. Thank you all for coming, and thank you all for the students sitting behind me. Without any further ado, please announce Dr. Grant Payne conducting the Chimes of Liberty March. People get tired of hearing me tell this story. So if you've heard this, I apologize. It was, I believe the year was 1999. Well, I know it was 1999, April 20th of 1999. It was a tragedy at Columbine High School. And when I was at Youngstown State University, I had the privilege of escorting famous people around campus and picking them up at airports and things like that. And one of those privileges was to take Frank DeKelly from his hotel room with my family to pick him up and took him to lunch at the Cooker restaurant when it was in Boardman. And it was during that lunch with my wife and my kids when Frank was across the seat from us and his cell phone rang, and it was the band director at Columbine High School who asked him to write a piece in memory of those who had lost their lives at Columbine. And the result was American Elegy, and it's been one of my favorite pieces ever since. I always cherish a band that I can do it with, and this is certainly one of those bands. We feature the talents of Alicia Smith on the oboe, as well as my dear friend Susan Sexton from the balcony with the trumpet solo. American Elegy by Frank DeKelly.
Thank you.
such soul. They say we're judged by the company we keep, and if that's the case, I am a really lucky guy. I'm blessed to have fantastic colleagues in my life, and also great students, such as these back here. They're not really my students. They're there for a few hours every Tuesday night, and I'm so thankful for that. But one of the young men I'm speaking of right now that I'm just blessed to be a part of his life, his name is Todd Wasoski. And he's our percussion advisor. He played in this ensemble. Tyler, where are you? Tyler, are you here? When did you play this ensemble? 2004. Back in my first stint with Youngstown in the Stambaugh Youth Concert Band. Tyler was yes, very long. And he didn't know there was going to be a test. But he was a professional advisor several years back, and then he got a job at Jackson Milton. He's doing a phenomenal job at Jackson Milton, and now he's come back to be our percussion advisor. And our percussion ensemble is going to play a piece for you, and I hope I pronounce it right. It's called Tree Pack. Is that right? Tree Pack. Our percussion ensemble, directed, but apparently not directed, because he's up way up there. By Tyler Wasoski. Tree Pack. Another one of those people I'm blessed to be part of their life and that I associate myself with is Dr. Grant Payne. What a great piece of news it was that he was going to come on board with me with the Stambaugh Band this year. I'm so very thankful for him. So we had some really, really great years with David Guan and obviously myself and Stephen Gage and Tom Roth over the years. But Grant Payne and I, we have a really good partnership and we really have to work together and the students, I think, benefit from his presence here, his musicianship, and his leadership. So I welcome Brad Payne to the podium again for English Folk Song Suite.
Good evening. Thank you all for being here this evening. It's an honor to spend time every Tuesday evening with the students you see here on stage, and I'm really enjoying my first semester as it's coming to a close here with the Stambaugh Band and looking forward to next spring. Just a few thank yous I'd like to share. My great colleague, Mr. Vineski, he's a fantastic person to work with, our librarian, Mr. Babel, and also, too, I'd like to thank Mr. Durham for the opportunity to be here, and also to my terrific colleague and friend, Dr. Gage at the Davis School of Music. And perhaps most importantly, the terrific speech you hear that you see on stage. I think normally when you attend events such as this or honor day concerts, you hear how great your students are, and that never gets old. And they are a great group of students to work with. It's the evening that I always look forward to, and kind of a nice pause, I'm sure, for them from their weekly activities at school. And I just want to thank all of you parents, grandma and grandpas, aunts and uncles, who support the activity you see happening on the stage. In a time of need where bottom lines and test scores dictate a lot of policy, especially in schools, it's terrific to see a group such as this taking place with five students from Northeast Ohio. So thank you for all you who support these students.
for our final number, I'm not sure. I think Brian spoke of some names, but I'm going to speak of them again. A lot of people to thank. First of all, my colleague Brent Payne, Eric Babel. Do you have a good librarian in your band director, or orchestra director, or choir director, or a musician of any type? If you have a good librarian, you're in luck. And we have an outstanding librarian in Eric Babel. So I thank Eric for his tireless work of organization and getting music to the kids and copies when we needed them and extra and all that business. So Eric, fantastic job, thank you. I already mentioned Tyler Rusowski, masterful job with our percussion section. Matt Pajak and his crew, Rising Sun. I do believe they have CDs for sale, so please stop at the table. I don't know if your programs have them in them, but Rising Sun's recording this evening, and should be a nice CD. Dr. Steve Gage, who is just a great friend, a dear friend, and a colleague, and somebody who is an unending source of pride and support for this ensemble, and somebody that we can trace the roots back to Stephen Gage. Speaking of roots of the ensemble, Tom Gorth, our executive director, who does incredible work behind the scenes. His passion for this ensemble is absolutely unmatched, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate Tom's confidence in me and us and what we do. So thank you so much, Tom. Parents, I know the parents are here. I know there's grandparents here, and aunts and uncles, and friends, and neighbors, and thank you for all you do to support these students behind me. I'm not sure you know how much that means. Obviously, directors, I know how much I hate to stand up as a director. You know, I didn't do last Saturday. Everybody stand up and teach these children, but there are countless directors and private instructors, musicians in this audience who teach these students on a regular basis, in some cases on a daily basis. I thank you so much for allowing your students and sharing your students with us, you know, Tuesday nights. I'm not sure you know how much I'm grateful for that. And most of all, these students behind me, who week in and week out come and make music. I've often thought of doing this, and I think I did it once early in my career, where I recorded an ensemble at the first reading. I think I did it when I was at South Range, way back when. The first reading of the concert literature, and then at the concert, I think I played at least a portion of the recording of the piece we were going to do at that concert, and then we did the piece on the concert, as you can imagine the difference. This ensemble and my friend Tom Roof, sitting back in the midst of the rehearsals this evening, made a statement, because he was here early on in the rehearsal process of these students taking on this literature, and he was just so complimentary on how much progress they had made, and that they sounded like such a band. So I appreciate these students for their part. I know they practice, I know they study, I know they do everything known to man, probably at their schools. In the springtime, I'll pay tribute to our seniors who, it's almost an embarrassing list of activities that these students behind me participate in their schools and their home and their life and their spiritual life and their leadership life. And I appreciate them for the fact that they take time out of their busy schedules to come and spend some time with us here on Tuesday night. So thank you so much, students. You get a band. As I was backstage, it occurred to me that we're going to do this all over again. We start up. That's really bad English, but we begin again on January 10th. It's a Tuesday. On January 17th, in case I forget to announce it, the senior solo auditions on January 17th at Rehearsal. So senior soloists. And then Wednesday, April 18th, is our spring concert featuring our senior soloists. Or last year we had two senior soloists, so who knows? We got a lot of fantastic senior musicians in this ensemble, so that program will feature those senior soloists, and we hope you're here. That's a Wednesday night. We're back on schedule. Tuesday night dress rehearsal and Wednesday night concert. And please come back on April 18th and enjoy our spring concert. The next piece, Alfred Breed's Russian Christmas Music, is probably some of you are familiar with it. It really is an any Christmas music that you're familiar with. It's Russian Orthodox. Choral kind of music, vocal music, and some beautiful, beautiful melodies and vignettes or scenes from the Russian Orthodox musical tradition. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful collection of scenes, musical scenes from Russian Orthodox and Christmas. We hope you enjoy Alfred Breed's Russian Christmas music. We're We've done it many times, so we directors do many times with antiphonal brass, and I think 3 or 4 years ago I did it with handbells and antiphonal brass. And I had this bright idea, since we have a newly refurbished, beautiful Skinner organ here. How many of you have heard this organ, this instrument yet? If you just vision it. Oh yes, well you can clap. Okay. Yeah. Well, if you haven't, if you have, you don't train for it, but if you haven't trained for a treat, my colleague Jeff DeCesare and I scored some organ for the last several phrases of it instead of having antiphonal brass. And we hope you enjoy the sounds of the organ played by a phenomenal human being, teacher, educator, musician, organist, leader, Dr. Ronald Gould. Russian Christmas music by Alfred Reed.
Thank you. that loud enough? He pulled out all the stops. He did. Boom. Pulled out all the stops. Thank you so much. Please be careful. I don't know if it's snowing or raining or whatever. A year ago, it was snowed out, if you remember. And be careful on the way home. See you in April. Happy, well, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Thank you very much.